Today, we honor the man who was largely responsible for bringing the beloved Sea Dogs to Portland. Dan Burke passed away in October, but his memory will live on forever here at Hadlock Field. Dan was born in upstate New York, raised in New England. His father was a die-hard Red Sox fan who raised Dan to be the same. He attended the University of Vermont, and after graduating, served the country in Korea as a first lieutenant in the United States Army. He returned home, earned a business degree, and married Bunny Shore, who would be his wife for 54 years. In 1961, Dan accepted a position as general manager of a television station in Albany, New York. The station was owned by Capital Cities Broadcasting. And for the next 35 years, Dan and Tom Murphy led the company from its humble beginnings as a station owner to the largest media company in the world after its acquisition of ABC in 1986. Warren Buffett, another baseball fan, helped fund the merger and once said that having Murphy and Burke in the same company was like having Ruth and Gehrig in the same lineup. Dan had always planned to retire as CEO of Capital Cities ABC on his 65th birthday in 1994. As the date approached, he began to develop a plan to fulfill a dream to bring minor league baseball to his beloved state of Maine, the place he had spent every summer of his life since 1955. But it would be no easy task, as other attempts to make baseball work in Maine had failed, and the economy of the early 1990s was struggling. But through sheer determination and the incredible support of the city of Portland, Burke managed to secure a Double-A franchise when the major leagues expanded to add the Colorado Rockies and Florida Marlins. Dan did retire from his media career in February 1994, and on April 18th, the Florida Marlins Double-A affiliate Portland Sea Dogs played their first game at a sold-out Hadlock Field. Kathy Lee Gifford was on hand to sing the national anthem. From day one, the team received incredible support from the fans in Portland, setting an Eastern League record for attendance in its very first season. Dan Burke was at nearly every home game, taking in the sights and sounds of his beloved game of baseball. Through the help of Charlie Eschbach and his terrific staff, the team achieved Dan's goal of providing a fun, affordable environment for families to enjoy the great game of baseball. And while the game on the field always captured his attention, nothing gave Dan Burke more satisfaction than looking out into the stands on a beautiful summer night and seeing parents and children enjoying a great time out together as a family. After several successful seasons with the Marlins, the Sea Dogs became an affiliate of the Boston Red Sox in 2003. And as such, they were part of the organization when they finally won a World Series title in 2004. And it was an incredible thrill for Dan Burke, a child of New England, to receive his very own Red Sox World Series ring. The Sea Dogs would achieve a similar milestone in 2006 when Portland defeated the Akron Arrows to capture their first Eastern League championship. Since becoming a Red Sox affiliate in 2003, many of Boston's biggest stars have made their way through Portland, including Clay Buchholz, Jacoby Ellsbury, John Lester, Jonathan Papelbon, Dustin Pedroia, and Kevin Youkilis. Red Sox Executive Vice President General Manager Ben Cherington called Burke the caretaker of the Portland Sea Dogs players and future big leaguers. He is an important part of the Red Sox family. The players enjoy playing in Portland just as much as the fans have enjoyed watching them. Former Sea Dogs pitcher Ryan Cameron said, "I made many stops in my 10-year minor league career, but none compared to my experience in Portland and playing for a gentleman named Dan Burke. From the day I showed up in Portland in 2003, I knew I was in a special place." Maine Senator Susan Collins said Dan Burke not only brought professional baseball to Portland, he also helped give the community a way to come together.
"And I think, frankly, something happens to me, my family will have it here for a long time."
Thanks to the efforts of Dan Burke and his family, over 7 million fans have been able to enjoy Portland Sea Dogs baseball. More than 500 players have donned the Sea Dogs uniform, chasing their dream of playing Major League Baseball. 187 of them would have that dream realized, and 20 of them would become Major League All-Stars. Dan Burke will be remembered every time you hear the words, "Play ball," at Hadlock Field.